The housing market in the U.S. is having its best year since 2006. Sales of existing homes were at more than 5 million in 2020. Home sales were helped by record low mortgage rates. But the demand has meant the average price for a home has increased nearly 13% at about $309,000.
Fans will be in the stands for this year's Super Bowl. NFL Commissioner Roger Goodell says 22,000 fans will be in attendance at Raymond James Stadium in Tampa for the Super Bowl on February 7th. That's about a third of the stadium's capacity. That number will include 7,500 vaccinated healthcare workers from the Tampa and Central Florida area who will get free tickets as a thank you.
Fans will have to wait even longer for the latest James Bond film. No Time to Die, starring Daniel Craig, has been pushed back yet again due to coronavirus concerns. The 25th Bond movie was originally set to debut in November of 2019, but it was postponed to April of 2020 when the director left the project. Then the pandemic struck, forcing multiple delays. The target date is now October. MGM is adamant about bringing the spy movie to the big screen and not streaming it first.
A famous painting could fetch top dollar at Sotheby's Masters Week sale in New York next week. The painting, dubbed Young Man Holding a Roundel, is a 15th century work of art created by Sandro Botticelli. According to the Associated Press, the artwork could fetch $80 million.
The viral image of Bernie Sanders and his mittens at the presidential inauguration has made its way onto the side of the Shop Local Kentucky warehouse in Lexington. Artist Ben Runko is behind the mural, and a lot of people have been stopping by the shop on Woodland Avenue for selfies. There you go, five things to know before you go to bed.